welcome to a brand new series where it is
all
about
Jesus.
Yes, she got it.
She got it.
And welcome to
our new teacher with us. We have a new teacher. Her name is Miss Andrea. Say, hey, Miss Andrea. They said, hey, Miss Andrea.
I know. I miss y'all.
You miss them. There's some people you don't even know.
Oh, well, I'm just talking to the people that I love.
That's right. But you love everybody.
I do. See,
that's
it.
That's right. We're excited about her. Excited about her being here. So it's all about Jesus. It's a brand new series.
Yes, it is.
And we're excited about what the next few weeks will be bringing us in this study of where we talk about Jesus. Hey, what does Jesus mean to you?
Oh, he's my savior and my friend.
Okay, what does Jesus mean to you?
Everything.
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 All right. Sometimes we sing, he's my all in all. Mm-hmm. It means he's everything to what we need in our life right now. But today, we're going to talk about a very, very specific part of Jesus. Well, really, before he even gets here. Mm-hmm. Before he even gets here. I can't think of anybody better to kick us off.
Okay.
Then Mr. Dale.
Yes, he's been doing a great job. So.
Yeah. And so Mr. Dale's going to talk to us a little bit about, well, what did God have in plan when Jesus came?
Hey kids, we're ready to start a new quarter with classes. I'm all excited about it. You're going to talk about my favorite thing to talk about. You're going to talk about my favorite person. That's Jesus Christ. You know, the Bible says so much about him. In fact, the Bible is all about Jesus. That's what this book is about. Isaiah writes that Jesus would be born and that he would be born from a young lady, a lady who was a virgin, a lady who had never been married and never been with a guy. And it's really a neat, neat story. The neatest thing about that is Isaiah told about that nearly 750 years before it happened. You know, imagine taking an arrow and going out into a field and putting a blindfold on and putting a target in the middle of that field and shooting the arrow up in the air and it coming down and you start looking for the arrow and you look all over the field and you find out that arrow was right in the center of the target. That's what a prophecy is. It's something that was 100% accurate, 100% true, and right on target. It's amazing. It doesn't just happen. It happened because God inspired Isaiah to know that. That's one of the great things about the Bible. It'll always be right. Kids, I hope that you'll remember the Bible is always true and always right, and that it is the book that's all about Jesus.
Hey kids, it's time for Sing Along Time, and we are excited about the two songs we're going to sing for you right now. And the first one you know very, very well because it's all about
Jesus!
Jesus!
Y'all are so smart. Y'all are so smart. We got new shirts.
Just in case we forgot.
Just in case we forgot, we got the shirts to remind us who we are. We're going to sing Jesus Loves the Little Children. Y'all ready?
Yes.
All right, here we go. Let's go together. Jesus loves the little children, all the children of the world. Red and yellow, black and white, they are precious in his sight. Jesus loves the little children of the world.
That was good.
We did well.
Yes.
Didn't even have to practice it.
No, uh-uh.
Like the second one we're going to do.
Oh, we got it. This is a fun one. It's a fun one.
This is a fun one. But you can't do this sitting down. You cannot do this one sitting down. So you got to stand up, all right? Stand up, Andrea.
She's got it.
You got it. So this is our fun one. It's called King in the Jungle.
King in the Jungle.
Another King in the Jungle. And we've worked on this really, really hard.
Uh-huh.
Really hard. But we want you to all sing along with us, all right? You ready? Here we go. And who's the king of the jungle? Ooh, ooh. Who's the king of the sea? Blah, 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 blah. Who's the king of the universe? Who's the king of me? His name is J-E-S-U-S. Yes, he's the king of me. He's the king of the universe, the jungle and the sea. Blah, blah, blah. Who's the king of the jungle? Ooh, ooh. Who's the king of the sea? Blah, 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 blah. Who's the king of the universe? And who's the king of me? Jesus!
Hi guys, we are getting ready to do a game. We're actually having a competition.
with the Hale family today. Uh-huh, so, uh-huh. Hi Hales, you're going
good
to
luck.
Lose.
Good luck. Jerry, come on now. Good attitude here.
It's a good attitude. Good That's attitude. A good attitude. We're going to win. So what we're doing is, what's this basically called? It's like, you're going to...
Tinsel wrap.
It's a tinsel wrap.
Yeah, you're kind of like a Christmas tree a little bit. We're going to wrap you in tinsel. We're going to put...
I am wearing the green today. That's right. Got the green on.
Lots of bows.
Huh?
Whoever can do it the fastest wins.
That's right. Whoever does it the fastest, right?
Yes.
All right.
Are you sure we didn't need to practice? I think they're going to do really well. Come on.
Uh-huh. Okay. All right.
All right, so who's going to give me on your mark, get set, go deal, right?
All right, I'll do it.
Okay. All right, here we go now.
All right.
I'm sure the Hale family's ready. They're ready to go. All right, here we go. Okay.
On your mark, get set, go! Okay. Ooh, where's the end?
Come on, guys, y'all get faster than this. Come on, move it. Make me look beautiful.
Spin, Jerry.
Look, I'm all sparkly. I feel like popping.
Okay, don't spin.
Spin.
This is the faster way. That's your. Okay, we're good.
Catch me, I'm falling.
What am I supposed to do? Wait. Hold on, stand very still, man.
The room is spinning, okay?
Okay. Oh, there's a way right there. Wait, right there. Hold on. Wait a minute, okay. We're good.
Okay, we'll see who the winner is, and we'll announce that in a little bit later.
All right, we'll see.
Thank you. So I am so glad that we won the game.
We won the game. We were quick. I mean, we were.
I'm pretty sure the Hales were pretty fast.
We were pretty fast. Oh, yeah. Those girls, they're quick.
What do you got?
Oh, I brought a clothespins. Oh. What do you think?
It's a clothespin.
That's nice.
Yeah. I like it.
Well, I've got a purpose for this.
Are you gonna do something with it?
Yeah. We're gonna do crafts. I know we can't.
It's a clothespin.
Yes, it is a clothespin. But we're gonna use this clothespin and make something great.
Oh.
To help remind the kids of our Bible lesson.
It doesn't really sound like it's gonna be really great.
I know.
It's just a clothespin.
Ouch. No, that's not a good idea. Don't try that at home. Yeah. But we're going to add to it. It's going to be a really great craft.
Okay.
And it'll help remind the kids of our lesson today. Do you want to see the finished product?
I think I do.
Yeah?
Well, anything's got to be better than two sticks of wood with a spring in the middle.
I know. All right, kids. This is what you're going to be making this week to help remind you of our Bible lesson.
How cool is that? Hey, hold it just like that.
Okay.
And now we're going to zoom in on that right there. We're going to zoom in and look. And you're going to see, it's me. It's an angel. That's really cool.
Yeah. So ordinary clothespin, yes. Yeah. But turned out pretty
okay,
cool.
Okay, so
beautiful.
The kids are going to do this craft. How do they get the craft?
Yeah. So I'm going to put together supply bags for them, and they are going to pick them up on Sunday morning after worship, or they can pick them up from my house. I'm going to have a box outside my front door on the front porch. They can come by anytime next week and pick up a bag, one per child, and they can make it at home.
An angel. And it does bring me back to what we want to talk about for just a little bit.
The Bible has
a great story about an angel. In fact, in the book of Luke, it says, in the sixth month, the angel, like his name, Gabriel.
Yep.
Gabriel was sent by God to a city of Galilee named Nazareth to a young lady engaged to a man whose name was Joseph. An angel comes and knocks on your door.
Wow.
That's pretty big.
Yeah.
It's pretty big. That's right. I mean, that's
pretty big.
So when he comes, and look what he says. And her, by the way, her name is Mary.
Yes, her name
just
want to
make
Mary.
Sure. Right. So he had come into her, and the angel said to her, "Rejoice, highly favored one. The Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women."
Highly favored?
Wow.
He called her highly favored.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I don't know what that means.
Well, if you're favored, they like you.
He likes you, and something else is coming, right?
Yeah.
Something else is coming. Yeah, I would be a little concerned. What else does it say?
Okay.
That's a huge compliment. compliment.
That's a great compliment.
Yeah. It's a really, I mean, the angel of the angel from God said, "You are highly favored." Mm-hmm. That's pretty big. Mm-hmm.
And knock on that door.
Right.
Okay. All right. So okay, here's what it says. The angel said to her, "Don't be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God." There's highly favored.
Highly favored. Well,
favored with who?
With God.
There you go.
Wow.
There you go. I like that. I like that. And here's where he leaves this message. He says, "Behold, you will conceive and you will bring forth the Son, and you will call his name Jesus." Mm-hmm. That's pretty cool.
That's pretty cool.
So I gotta back up here. Dale would use this great analogy. Just imagine taking a bow and arrow, mm-hmm. and you just shoot the arrow up in the air, and it comes and comes and comes and comes, and you don't see where it goes. Mm-hmm. But you go looking for it. And when you look, you see that it hit the bullseye right dead center.
God knew what he was doing from the very beginning of time.
That's right.
He knew this was going to happen, and he put a plan in place.
Yeah. So he knew 700 years ago mm-hmm. that it was going to be Mary.
Yeah.
I mean, how special is she?
You think about that. You think about that. And he knew that he tells this messenger, this angel, go knock on Mary's door. Mm-hmm. It wasn't Susie to the right, and it wasn't Jenny to the left.
Right.
It was Mary in the middle.
Yeah.
Like that, Mary in the middle. That's pretty good. But it was Mary. So that's the greatest thing. And we talk a little bit about how special and how beautiful something is. Mm-hmm. And that's exactly what Mary was in this case.
She was highly favored.
Highly favored.
Yeah.
Highly favored.
Chosen.
Very special.
Yeah.
Today in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you.
All right, so that was the memory verse, memory challenge.
Yeah, we saw the memory challenge, uh-huh. and we want you to be working on the memory challenge
yes.
as well with the hand motions and,
that's right.
and everything
Hope
else.
Hope you learn it a little bit. We don't have a song.
You're all about songs and like, you know.
Hey, if there's something that can help us learn God's Word, I'm all about it.
I'm all about
Whether
it,
Whether it's a song or hand motion or... You know, a craft to help remind us.
All right. Speaking of this, okay.
Okay.
Let's reel it in.
Okay.
Let's pull it all in.
Huh? Are you fishing? Reeling it in. Okay. Go ahead.
Trying to, no comment. Okay. So we'll reel it in. How does this work? We talk about things that are ordinary. Mm-hmm. All right. So what? What's this mean? What do we mean by this? I mean, you're trying to make something out of something that's just plain and simple?
Yeah. Like the clip? Yeah, like the clip. Just an ordinary clip. Now, it has a purpose, but, you know, it's just kind of plain. Not a whole lot going on there.
But.
Right? But.
When you add some things to it.
Yeah. It turns into something pretty special.
You get a beautiful angel.
That's right.
And so.
Yeah. And kind of like our game, too. Right? We had all these little pieces. Individually.
I think she's saying there was just an ordinary Jerry. I think that's what she's trying to say.
So yeah, you know, all these
ordinary
little pieces,
Jerry.
But putting them all together
makes
something extraordinary. Yeah.
Tinsel. Twirl.
Twirl.
Uh-huh.
Bones.
Easy.
Yeah.
So in looking at the lesson that we have today, Mary was not any more special than the person that lived next door to her, right?
Average Joe. Average person, right?
Average Mary. Yeah.
Yeah.
So, but God sees her more than that.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Yeah, he knew her potential. She knew what she was capable of and the faith, the trust, you know, that would be required.
Okay.
He knew that she could do that.
Okay. Which this kind of gives us a little booster about, we want to remind people that coming up on Wednesday night,
mm-hmm.
on Wednesday night, and this is the way this series is going to be going. We're going to have a larger lesson on Sundays, and then on Wednesdays, we're going to kind of have like a tag to it.
That's right.
And we're going to talk a little bit more about some trusting things mm-hmm. on Wednesday when we get around to it. Okay, so just that's the number for Wednesday.
Mm-hmm.
But I'm still trying to grasp this whole concept of, you know, here's this ordinary young lady that God has chosen to become extraordinary. And how does that apply to me? I mean, we see Johnny and we see Susie and even Mr. Jerry and Miss Andrea and Miss Angie.
Ordinary. Plain.
But an extraordinary teacher, and the kids know that. Yeah. God has given us all gifts and abilities. And when we trust in Him and when we use those gifts and things, with His help, we do extraordinary things.
I like that. I really like the fact that we need to allow God to use us, mm-hmm. to make us better.
Yeah.
Because that's exactly what y'all did when you made ordinary Jerry into extraordinary tinsel.
Christmas Jerry.
Christmas.
Yeah. It was Christmas time.
Yeah, right. Uh-huh. Wrapped up, tied up. So.
And Mary was just Mary.
Right.
She was just Mary until she became Mary, the mother of Jesus.
Mm-hmm. Right.
Something mm-hmm. extra special.
And she didn't have to be scared about it because even God told her, don't be afraid. Mm-hmm. Don't be afraid.
He was with her. And, you know, our kids, it's not that they have to do amazing, extraordinary things. They could go talk to a friend and say, we're having Bible class videos online. Mm-hmm. You're welcome to watch them. They're, you know, they've been great.
Yeah.
Or just saying hi to somebody or, you know, being a friend.
Awesome. Well, it's going to wrap us up for today.
Okay. All right.
I'm excited about this.
I think it's going to be good.
Thank you guys for watching. We appreciate it. And we'll be back again Wednesday night with a little bit shorter version with another part of this lesson. It's all
about
Jesus.